Firefox. In this video, I will walk you through the process of integrating Cloudera Manager with OpenLDAP. Okay, so I have a Cloudera Manager, Cloudera cluster, so which is installed in Amazon AWS. So this is my credential. So you can use your initial admin credential, and this is the admin user. So you can go to the admin session tab and see the users, select the user. So here you have option to add the user. So but whatever the user we add will be added to Cloudera Manager's local database. Suppose if you have a centralized authentication mechanism such as LDAP or Active Directory, so you can integrate Cloudera Manager with LDAP or Active Directory. So in this case, I will walk you through the process of integrating OpenLDAP with Cloudera Manager. And for this feature, so you require either Cloudera Manager, Cloudera Enterprise version, or Enterprise Trial version. So we can check the version and verify the version here. So this is Enterprise Data Hub Edition Trial. So either you require a trial or Enterprise Edition. Express Edition won't support this feature. Okay, so before going this, you need to make sure so you are in using this particular, I mean Enterprise Data Hub Edition. Okay, now so I have already configured an OpenLDAP service, so you can refer my previous videos for that. So I am logging with my credential. So here, so what I am doing here is, okay, I think I don't know why it's showing like this. Yeah, here I have a lot of groups and organization unit and other thing, but for Cloudera authentication, so I'm using a separate group. Okay, so let me go to the my main tree, and under that, so I'm going to create a create a child entry under here, and I'm going to create an organization unit, so that as Cloudera. Okay, okay, so this name looks like O equal to Cloudera, DC equal to Hadoop, and DC equal to com. Make a note of this entry, commit. Okay, so I have an organization unit. Okay, so let me do a logout and login. So I think okay, so here I have an organization unit Cloudera. So I'm going to create some more user under a user and group under this organization unit. Okay, so POSIX group, and the group name is Cloudera admin or CM admin, I can use in short CM admin, and I'm just creating that group. And under that, so I'm just going to create as a couple of users here. So generic user, okay, Cloudera user, okay, so user ID is C user, and the password I'm typing here is password, and okay, so why I am using a separate organization unit here is I don't want to give access to everyone. So I want to restrict my access to the people who belongs to this particular group. Okay, so I'm going to create a user one for testing purpose. I'm just creating one user. Yeah, that's it. And whatever the default shell I can give, and then create the object. Commit. So now I have created the users and group inside my organization unit, and okay, so let me Okay, make a note of this entry. And for adding authentication, I mean for adding external authentication, first log in as admin user and go to the administration settings, then filter by using external authentication. Just click this part. Here we have option maybe default database only, so that means the Cloudera manager will always look into the default database. So we have alternate options also, then external, then database. So that means first it will check the external authentication mechanism, then it check its local database. Okay, and here also we have option, so Active Directory or LDAP. So if you are using Active Directory, so you can select this Active Directory entry and following details. So I'm using LDAP, so LDAP, then LDAP URL. So LDAP URL is the so this consists of machine IP and the port information where our LDAP is running. So I have saved those entries like this. Okay, so you can just copy that and pasting here, so it looks like LDAP colon for followed by 2/ then the IP address of the machine where I hosted my open LDAP and 389. So this is the port where LDAP is running. And then bind user distinguished name. So bind user is something similar to the super user. Okay, so I can in my case it's CN equal to manager, so DC equal to Hadoop and DC is equal to com. And bind user password is a password for this particular user. So you might remember the password that you have given while configuring your open LDAP. So again, if you are relying on Linux administrator, so you can ask them to provide these details. So they will provide this bind username and password, everything. Okay, so we'll give the password here, password. Then this one we can ignore. Then the next thing we need to is user search filter. Okay, so LDAP user search filter, use this value LDAP user search base. Okay, so user search base here, so I want to search my user from this particular tab. That means under organization unit Cloudera, then DC is equal to Hadoop and DC is equal to com. So I don't want to search entire tree, so I want to search from only this particular organization unit. Then group search filter, so that is also okay. Use group search filter, you can use this particular value, object class equal to POSIX group. Group search base, that is also the same as user search base, because we are searching the groups from the same organization unit. And here we have some options like okay, setting to who all are belongs to super user and who all are belongs to normal user. So I'm not giving that values, I'm just keeping as it is. So LDAP distinguish name pattern, so here I'm giving this like my username distinguish name pattern. So here instead of CM user, so I need to use Cloudera, so which is my organization unit name. So I have set all these values. So next I am saving these changes. Okay, so once it is saved, so here you can see this all requests. So wherever you do, you can see this requests a server restart. So you need to go and restart this service. Okay, so go to the machine where Cloudera manager is running and use service Cloudera SSCM server restart. So I'm going to restart my Cloudera manager service. So again, once it is restarted, it takes some time. So after that only you will be getting this 7180 URL. So once you try it immediately after restarting, you won't get the page. So wait some time. So it may take 2 to 3 minutes. After that only you would be able to log in. So now I got this Cloudera manager window. Okay, so my Cloudera manager is up and running. So now I would be able to so let me check the username which I created in this organization unit. So Cloudera user, and his username, okay, so username is C user. So let me log in with that C user and try the password, whatever the password we have set here. Okay, so use the same password. Yes, that's it. So I'm able to log in with that user. Okay, so this is now the operator by default operator role. So not have admin privileges. So we can set that by using admin. Okay, so let's check this here, admin, and go to the administration and users. Here we have option to change that privilege. Okay, so we have assign role, and again, so we have quite a large number of roles available, so you can select any one of that. This is how authentication works. Okay, so we have C user and admin. So let me try create another user also. Okay, so I CM user. Okay, so I just need a user like this. So there is no user like CM user. Okay, so I'm just going to create that user here in my organization unit Cloudera. Okay, so create a child entry, then a user account, then Cloudera user. Okay, so let me try rename it like this, CM user. This is the one which I need. Then give the password, any password you can set. Password and the group name. Okay, so I'm just adding this one as group, and whatever the shell. Commit. So I just created one user. This already exists. Think somewhere it exists. Okay, no problem. So let me try no. Okay, so I need the user here. So let's create another user. Create a child entry, then user account, something like that. Okay, ABCD EFGH. Okay, so my user ID is this one, and I can set the password. Then shell CM admin, and whatever the shell which we want. Then that's it, create the user. So commit. Okay, so we have that user here. So what is the user ID? AEFGS. So let's try to log in with that user also and use its password. Okay, so now this user also able to log in. So whatever the user you create inside this organization unit would be able to log in. But I have some other users and group here. So this is the user. Okay, so if I try to log in with this user, so it won't be able to log in. So let me try that. This one, and whatever the password for that user, no. So this is not able to login. Why? Because in the configuration file, so we have exclusively mentioned from where we need to search. So I created a separate organization unit, and I am trying to find my users under that organization unit alone. Okay, so whatever the users I create under that organization unit would be able to authenticate to Cloudera manager. So this is how we can integrate Cloudera manager with Open LDAP. Okay, so I hope so you enjoyed this content. So if you like, so please like the video and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye.